Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everyone.
Praise the Lord.
Come on, this is a celebration of life. Come on, praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise
no matter how you're feeling right now, God is still God.
Amen.
Amen. So we are here to uplift his name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We're not going to even prolong this celebration. We're just going to go right on into it. And we're going to start things off with a word of prayer. Would everyone bow their heads, please? Father God, we thank you right now for this day that we've never seen.
Thank you,
Father, we thank you for life. We thank you for health, and we thank you for the strength. Father, we thank you for the small things that we forget to give you praise for. God, we ask you now to just touch this family. Lay your comforting hand on everyone, God. Everyone has a remembrance. And God, just let them keep that happy moments. And God, we will be ever so careful to lift your name up in praise every time we think about Brother Hadley. God, we thank you right now in advance for what you're going to do in our lives.
Yes.
It is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to have the reading of the scriptures, the Old Testament from Apostle Jarvis Travis and the New Testament from Apostle Dorothy Travis.
Good morning. Amen. Pastor Nelson said this is a celebration. Amen. Let's say that again. Good morning.
Good morning.
I will be reading from Isaiah, the 40th chapter, verse 23, 28 through 31. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the end of the earth. Neither faint nor is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. He give power to the weak, and to those who have no might, he increases strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young man shall utterly fall. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. The word of the Lord for the peoples of the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Let's give him one more praise. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
New scripture testimony will be coming from Thessalonians 4, 13 through 18. But we do not want you to be uninformed, brethren, about those who are asleep, that you may not grieve as do the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep in Jesus. For this we say to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord shall not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Amen. Then we who are alive and remain will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words. Amen. Word of the Lord for the people of the Lord.
At this time, we will have reflections. First, we will have the first reflection by Sheila Gambles as a brother.
Good morning, everybody. We're here to say goodbye to our brother. And yesterday we talked, and everybody know what was said. You know, we're going to miss him. But my brother, I'm just going to be quick, because I think about the goodness of God, and God was good to our family. There's 14 of us, and there's 12 of us living. So God has given us long life. Found out 2 years ago, they sent Michael home to die. But God gave us the time to tell him goodbye for this day. So I want to tell my brother that I love him. We all love him. And we're going to miss him so. And I hope that you all pray for our family, that we be strong in this time. Thank you.
The next reflection will be as a classmate from Sarah Williams.
Good morning. I'm going to speak on Mike as I knew him. As a friend, a buddy, my contractor, just everything. He was always, just like this picture, had that smile on his face whenever I met him. He loved it everybody. And one thing he told my son while he was there, he said, "Your mama helped me get out of school. I wish that worked." I used to do his work in class, pass him my paper, so he'll have paper on his desk, and I'll do his, and then I get it back. That was my friend. He never forgotten it. And this is our fifth year out of school, always with a smile. Always. Say, "Hey, Ruiz," every time I meet, huh? But thanks the Lord, I'm here to speak over him. Amen. And he can't get crowned till I get there.
Here we will have open remarks from anyone, please, and let's please limit it to 2 minutes. Anyone? Amen. Let's just press on. Miss Renee McKinnon will give us a lovely solo. How many agree with that? But I do. Where would I be without the Lord on my side? Amen. We'll be coming from John 14 today. John 14. I promise you I won't keep you long. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And where I go, you know, and the way you know. Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you're going, and how can we know the way?" And Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." First promise of Christians is that we don't have to fear death. Jesus said, "Don't let your hearts be troubled." And I think that trouble only creeps into our hearts when we don't know what is going to happen when we die. But Jesus has removed the fear, y'all, and the uncertainty from death. And I think that if Jesus were here in the flesh today, he would say those exact words. Don't let your heart be troubled. And if we could hear today, I'm sure we would listen to the similar words if he could explain heaven's incredible mysteries and wonders. But Jesus conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave and death. So there needs to be no fear in our eternal future. That means there is some good news this morning. Death had no hold on Jesus, nor does it have a hold on us. So as children of God, we have no fear and worry when it comes to death, because we know that death has been defeated. Amen. Unfortunately, we might never know why we lose the people we love. And even though there are many reasons for sorrow, almost nothing compares to the grief we experience at the death of a loved one. We know that God has promised that there will be some tough things in our life, and that we will experience some pain, we will experience some hurt. It's all a part of life. You're going to go through it. If you have not been through it, hold on, because your storm is coming. But God has promised that if we let him, we can go through all of it with him. Amen. And doing life, y'all, with him is just way better than doing life without him. So I encourage you all today not to get lost in the questions that you've been having in your mind, the whys, the what ifs and the pain, but rather get lost in the comfort and peace that God provides. God is a good God.
Yes, he is.
Amen. God is a good God.
Yes.
Even when life don't seem good, even when we don't think, even when we don't understand what's going on, God is still a good God. And we know that it doesn't mean God is no longer suitable. I know that there must be a whole lot of emotions going on right now. It is. Some of you are feeling some despair. Some of you are feeling sadness. Some may be feeling some numbness, and some probably have some anger. Some may have some resentment. Some of you have gratitude, though, for the time that you spent with him. Amen. And then the memories that you shared. Some of you might even regret the things that you didn't get to say to him. Whatever it is you're feeling, I want you to know that God makes this promise. He makes this promise in Psalm 46, it's verse 1 through 3. He says, God is our refuge and our strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear. And even though the earth be removed, and though the mountains are carried in the midst of the sea, though its waters roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with its swelling, we will not fear. That's why it's so vitally important, y'all, to give people their flowers while they're here.
Yes,
amen. It's vitally important to get stress off of you and go to your neighbor and talk to him. Say, I'm sorry. Drop your pride. Say, I'm sorry. Those two words right there are going to kill a whole lot of us at him. Because it's going to run your pressure because you're mad about what somebody so-called said. Give people their flowers while they're here. Amen. Settle all those arguments. Life is too short for foolishness. Amen. Some of you, that's how you're feeling today. Like the earth is just shaking and the mountains are crumbling down. I know it's never easy to say goodbye. It's not, to someone you love and care about. But I want you to know that God is our refuge. God, he's our strength. And that God shares in our suffering. He shares in our grief. God knows the loss that we feel. Jesus cried with Mary and Martha during the loss of their brother. But at the same time, God gives great hope in moments like these, because he's a very present help in times of trouble. We want to think, y'all, that all of us are entitled to a certain number of days, a certain number of weeks, months or years. But today is a reminder that nothing in this life is guaranteed. This is an appointment we all gotta keep.
Amen.
But a day like this puts our lives in perspective. We see so clearly what is most important, and it reminds us of how life, how short it is. No matter how long you live, It reminds us that each of us will one day have a funeral. Amen. And death will be a certainty for everybody out there. So we need to embrace life. Ride this thing till the wheels fall off. Enjoy it. Enjoy every day like it's your last day. Amen. Amen. We need to embrace life and love others because we never know. We don't know when our number gonna get picked. So we need to live each day as if it's the last because it very might well be your last day. He says, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. See if we can break a couple of things down. The way. Do you want to make sure your life is going in the right direction? Do you want to make sure that at the end of your life, it has been a life with some meaning and some purpose? Then Jesus is the way. Amen. He's not just a way. He is the way. He's the way of peace and joy, contentment, and eternal life. And there are people who have an addiction. There are. And they are looking for a way out. They're looking for a way out of that lifestyle. Jesus is the way out.
Amen.
Amen. There's going to be some difficult days. Yes, it is. Like today. And if you want help to get through those days, Jesus is the way. Somebody say the truth.
True.
Ever believe someone and found out later that they lied to you? Just say out your amen. It don't matter. Ever believe in something and you found out later that it was a lie?
Oh, yeah.
Well, when you put your trust in Jesus and place your life in his hands, you'll find out that he's the truth yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Somebody say the life. Ever heard someone say, get a life. Get a life. If you want a life that matters, a life means something. A life that can change the world around you. A life that will impact people's life. Jesus is the life. It also means that God is concerned about every aspect of your life. Y'all knew that? Every aspect. It means that if you don't have to go through these situations alone, God is automatically going to give you comfort in his word, to find comfort in the people he has placed around you. Now, everybody here have different moments that and memories of Brother Michael. So let's imagine for a brief moment, Brother Michael speaking to us right now in his own way. And imagine saying, y'all, I'm free. Don't grieve for me. For now I'm free. I'm following the path God has laid for me. You see, I took his hand when I heard him call, and I turned my back and I left it all. I could not stay another day. And I'm really not sorry because I'm free now. I'm free to laugh, to love, to work and play now. All the tasks left undone must stay that way because I found that peace at the close of the day. Whew, glory to God. If my parting has left a void, oh man, then fill it with a remembered joy of me. A friendship shared, a laugh, a kiss. Oh, yeah, these things I'm gonna miss too. I am. But be not burdened with times of sorrow because I wish you the sunshine of tomorrow. My life's been full, y'all. I savored much. Good friends, good times, a loved one's touch. Perhaps my time seem all too brief. So don't lengthen it now with undue grief. Lift up your hearts and peace to thee, because God wanted me now. Glory. And he set me free. It's easy for us to come to a cemetery and see places of despair. Yeah, to look at graves that are here and see what really is our common end in this life. And it's easy to look at all this and think that life is really short. Cemeteries, they seem like a place of final separation because from here, we leave and we go our own way. But for one moment in time, we all stood here and remembered Brother Michael, who touched our lives. And then we move on carrying only memories with us. But before we leave this place, I would like to share scripture with you. Job 19:25-27. But as for me, I know that my Redeemer lives, and he shall stand upon the earth at last. And after my body has decayed, yet in my body I will see God. I will see him for myself. Come on now. I will see him with my own eyes. I am overwhelmed at that thought. Our God is a God of sympathy, and he's a God of understanding. I know you're feeling hurt today, and you have every right, because there's nothing anybody could say to make you feel good. Nothing. We know you're hurting. But he knows you're hurting. He knows your pain. He knows how you're feeling. But you can find God at any time, and you can find him today. The Bible tells us that he knows our sorrow and records our tears. All our thoughts, ways, words are known to her. So it's comforting to have God, to trust. Yeah, and one with perfect love and absolute knowledge. It's good to have a God who knows everything about us and knows how to take care of everything that we have, even ailing us. In the name of Jesus. All those words that Jesus spoke apply to this family and friends today. You're not alone. For the Heavenly Father is with you. And God promises never to leave us nor forsake us. Can anybody say amen to that? Amen. I don't think there could be no more comforting words for you than God is with you. God's hand is upon you. When I pray with this sadness, you won't find bitterness. I pray that you don't find unforgiveness as well. That you will find more pain and regret, but that you will find more of God. This is a moment of reflection now. Lord, y'all, we need God more than ever before. The world is in a terrible mess right now, and we need God more than ever before, because he's going to always be there for our peace of mind, our strength, and our courage. Amen. Amen. Y'all, how many believe that? I mean, he's going to be there for you now. I don't care what you're going through. He's going to be there for you. Let's pray. Father, we thank you now, God, for everyone with listening ears. I pray, God, that it touched someone. I pray that it changed someone in some form or fashion. Let them reflect now that they need God even more than they did before they got here. And just say goodbye to their brother with a smile, because he's free now. No more pain. And God, we give you glory. We give you honor. And we give you praise. It is in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Say amen.
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 Amen. Amen. To the family, there's a poem on the inside of your programs that I'd like to share with you today during this special presentation. To my daughter, thank you for being the best blessing in my life. Time has passed us by, so please don't cry for me. I leave you all of my love and all my wishes for you. I wish you to be kind and generous, because that is what you are. I wish that you love deeply and let yourself be loved, because that is who you are. I wish that you will always trust God and trust in him always, because I see God in you. And your light shines so brightly. I wish that you will always know your worth, and that you deserve the best things in life. You are priceless and worthy of it all. I wish you to be fearless and always fight when times get hard, because being strong, my daughter, is who you are. But lastly, my dear daughter, I wish you well, and remember you have already been my greatest gift from God. To my daughter, love your dad, Michael. Let's give Mr. Michael Lewis Hadley's memory a round of applause at this time. Time accompany a song that simply says, thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for all of the love and the kindness, all of the support, and all of the memories that have been shared and shown during this time of bereavement. To those that have made phone calls, the family will always be grateful. Your visits brought smiles to their faces. Most importantly, your prayers are keeping them strong. And so we say thank you. If you know the power of prayer, the Hadley family would like for you to continue to pray for them in the days ahead, because we know that prayers will change all things. To those supporting us via live stream, the family does feel your support. And if they're not able to say thank you to each of you individually, I stand today to say thank you collectively. Amen. We would like to acknowledge a resolution that has been submitted from the Living Word Ministries of Lake City, Florida. Elder Sammy Daniels Sr. is the pastor. Amen. We say a special thank you for the message that was rendered on today. And please join me in thanking the messenger, Pastor Nelson. We're thankful for you, and let us give him a round of applause for a job well done. Amen. We're also thankful for Apostle Jarvis Travis, for being in attendance on today, as well as Apostle Dorothy Travis. God bless you. We're thankful for Dr. Kenneth Dupree. Thank you for being in attendance on today. Amen. And First Lady Nelson, thank you for being here today. Amen. If there are other ministers present, we're thankful for each of you one by one, name by name. May God bless and keep you is also our prayer. Amen. To the Hadley family, we love you, and we're hoping and praying that we've been helpful to you all during this time. If we help to erase at least one of your pains, just know that our goal has been accomplished. If you should need us, or if there's anything that any of us can do to make your days a little bit brighter looking forward, we're just a phone call away. On behalf of my dad, Mr. Jim McGhee Sr., and the entire Stevens-McGhee Funeral Home staff and family, always remember, Hadley family, that earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. Amen. Amen. I'd like to acknowledge at this time, the family has a special request. And so following the committal rites, we ask that you please keep your seats and keep your stance as they say their last goodbyes in a symbolic manner. Amen. We also want to acknowledge, while the staff is preparing the flowers, that Mr. Michael served his country, and he served his country well. And so because of his faithfulness and because of his dedication to this great nation, he has been awarded the flag from our great nation. Amen. And so immediately following our benediction for today, the flag will be presented to his family in memory of his faithfulness. Amen. Amen.
And now we ask Pastor Nelson to come back to the microphone to render the committal rites, the closing prayer, and the benediction.
Second Corinthians chapter 4, verse 17 through 18. For momentary, light affliction is producing for us an eternal weight of glory, far beyond all compassion. While we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal. So for as much as it has pleased the Almighty God in his mercy, to take back unto himself the soul of our beloved brother, Michael. We therefore commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, fulfilling the saying in Ecclesiastes, which is written, then the dust will return to the earth as it was, and the spirit will return to God who gave it. Thank you now, once again. But we never can say thank you enough. But you've always been there to comfort us and bless us. And God, we will continue to lift your name up in praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Also serve this country. Amen. Properly dismissed. We ask that if you're standing, please keep your stance as we offer the family members that are seated the first opportunity to stand and either keep your flowers as a token of remembrance or deposit them onto the casket as your version of a final goodbye. God bless you.